Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to discuss the topic that is cam and follower. So, the cam and follower is a device which can convert rotary motion, that is circular motion, into a linear motion, that is movement in a straight line. So, basically, cam and follower is used to convert the rotary motion into a reciprocating motion. That is the sole purpose of cam and follower. So here on this screen you can see a shaft, and on that shaft there are two cams which is mounted. The shaft is rotating with uniform velocity. That means your cam will rotate with uniform velocity, and in connection with the cam there are two followers. The followers are always in contact with the cam with the spring action. So as the cam rotates, the follower get reciprocates. So this is the function of cam and follower. So as the cam rotates, the cam has a rotary motion. So the cam will rotate with uniform velocity, and as the follower is in contact with the cam, it will reciprocate. The cam reciprocate inside the guide. So here in this diagram, you can see the cam has a rotary motion. Here you can see the cam has a rotary motion which is mounted over the shaft, and follower is in contact with the cam. The follower is shown in a red color. So as the cam rotates with uniform velocity, the follower will reciprocate. The follower will move up and down as the cam rotates. So the motion of the follower depends on the profile of the cam. As the profile of the cam changes, the motion of the follower will also affect. So in order to get a desired motion of the follower, we have to design the profile of the cam. So the motion of the follower depends on the profile of the cam. That I want to tell you here. Now we will discuss the types of cam. So the cam is nothing but a rotary member, and the cam can have various shape. These are known as cam profile. So as you change the shape of the cam, you will get different profiles of the cam. So here you can see the member in yellowish color, that is nothing but cam, and the member in green color, that is nothing but follower. So this is the first shape of the follower, first shape of the cam, which is nothing but pear shape. So here the cam is shown in blue color, and that cam has a pear shape. So as the cam rotates, the follower will reciprocate inside the guide, and the guides are shown with the help of red color. So here you can see how the guides are there and how the follower reciprocate inside the guide. The next shape, that is nothing but heart shape. So here you can see the member in blue color, that is nothing but cam, and it is in heart shape. The next type, that is circular cam. So here you can see the shape of the cam is circular. The next type, that is drop shape. So here you can see the profile of the cam is suddenly changed. So here you can see in earlier example, there is a constant profile of the cam, or there is a smooth profile of the cam. If you observe a pear shape, the profile of the cam is smooth. If you observe a circular shape, again the profile of the cam is smooth. Whereas in drop shape, the profile of the cam is suddenly changed. Okay, that is why there will be a jerk inside the follower. So this is the demand. This may be a demand, and as per your demand, you can design the various types of cam. That means you can generate the various types of cam profile as per your requirement. So these are nothing but different types of the cam shape, that is pear shape, heart shape, circular shape, or drop shape. Now we will discuss the various types of follower. So a follower is a component which is designed to move up and down as it follows the edge of the cam. So follower is nothing but a reciprocating member, and the cam is a rotary member. So as the cam rotates, the follower reciprocates. So follower is a component which is designed to move up and down as it follows the edge of the cam. So the motion of the follower depends on the shape of the cam. So here you can see the cam is in blue color. So as it rotates over the shaft, the follower reciprocates. That means the motion of the follower entirely depends on the shape of the cam. Now there are various types of follower. The first one, that is known as knife edge follower. So here you can see the end of the follower has a sharp knife edge. The edge of the follower has sharp knife edge. That is why this is known as knife edge follower. So there is a line contact in between cam and follower. Thus it constitutes a higher pair. So this I have already discussed in kinematics of machine. That is my first lecture. So I request you please watch that lecture. So we can classify the pairs on the basis of its contact. So cam and follower forms a kinematic pair because there is a relative motion in between cam and follower, right? And there is a line contact. So line contact constitutes a higher pair. When there is a line contact or point contact in between two pairs, then it will form a higher pair. And when there is a surface contact in between two pair, it constitutes lower pair. So here there is a line contact, that means it forms a higher pair. And the shape of the follower, that is the shape of the follower is in the form of knife. So the edge of the follower has a sharp pointed, or you can say a pointed edge, and that edge is in contact with cam. So this has a limitation because as there is a pointed contact in between cam and follower, so there will be a more stresses and there will be more wear and tear. So this is seldom in use. Then the next type. The next type that is nothing but flat face follower. So here you can see the shape of the follower is flat. In earlier example, there was a pointed edge over the follower, but here you can see the contact surface has a flat face. So this type of follower is known as flat foot or flat face follower. So there is less wear and tear as compared to knife edge follower. So this is more common in use as compared to knife edge follower. The next one, that is nothing but offset follower. In offset follower, the axis of the follower is at a certain distance from the axis of the cam. Here it is not properly shown, but you can imagine that the axis of the follower should be at certain distance to the axis of cam. That is nothing but offset follower. That is the third type of follower. Then the next type, that is roller follower. So in this diagram you can see at the end of the follower there is a roller. So here you can see at the end of the follower there is a roller. This is known as roller follower. Again, there is very less stresses or less friction in between cam and follower as the shape of the follower is in roller. So as the cam rotates, the follower will reciprocate and the contact surface has again line contact, because whenever two circles they are rolling over each other, they will generate a line only. So there is a line contact in every example and the cam and follower constitutes a higher pair. So these are nothing but different types of follower. Again, I will repeat. The first one is knife edge follower, second one flat face follower, third one offset follower, and fourth one is roller follower. Now we will discuss the next topic, that is nothing but lobes. So the bump on a cam are called as lobes. So with the example, I will try to explain what exactly the lobes is. So here you can see the shape of the cam, that is square. So as the square rotates, the follower will reciprocate, but there will not be uniform motion of the follower. The follower will experience certain types of jerks, and that jerks are nothing but the various bumps. Okay, and those bumps are called as lobes. Okay, so here in this diagram you can see as the cam rotates, the cam is in square shape, and as it rotates the follower reciprocates, but the motion of the follower is not uniform. It experiences certain type of jerks, and that jerks is nothing but lobes. So here we can see the different types of rotary cam follower which is having lobes. So the first example, which is shown in red color, so it is somewhat elliptical in shape. So here you can say the one side of the cam has a uniform shape. As it changes the side, the follower will experience the jerk. Again, second example, which is shown in blue color. Third example, which is shown in yellow color. So as the profile changes, the follower will experience the jerk, and that jerk is known as lobes. So this is nothing but different shapes of the cam. So it is not necessary that the cam is always have a circular shape. It may have any shape, and that shape depends on the desired motion of the follower. Now this diagram or the simulation is showing the working of cam and follower. Now here you can see the membrane decker, that is nothing but cam. So it is mounted on a camshaft. That camshaft is attached to the crankshaft, and through crankshaft it is taking power. So as the camshaft rotates, the member on it, that is nothing but cam, that will rotate, and the follower is connected with the cam. So as the cam rotates, the follower will reciprocate. Then this follower, here you can see the follower is attached to another member, which is shown in blue color, and that is attached to the wall. This wall may be head wall or exhaust wall. So as the cam rotates, the follower will reciprocate, and ultimately it is controlling either inlet wall or exhaust wall. So this is the working of cam and follower when it's used in IC engine. So most probably the cam and follower mechanism is found in IC engine. So for operating the inlet and exhaust wall of IC engine, cam and follower are used. So here you can see the working. So as the cam rotates, the follower reciprocates, and it actuates either inlet or exhaust wall or both. Okay, so it controls the movement of engine valve. Here you can see with the help of this simulation. Again, we can use the cam in pumps also. So here you can see the usage of cam in the pump. So with this simulation, you can easily understand how the pumps are operate or how the cams are used in a pump. So the next topic, the linear cam moves backward and forward in a reciprocating motion. So the example that we have seen before to this, in that the cam has most probably a rotary shape, and it is a rotating member. But sometimes it may happen that the cam may be a reciprocating member also. So with this simulation, you can understand how the cam has a reciprocating motion. So here you can see a linear cam and a linear follower. So the portion in yellowish color, that is nothing but cam, and it has a linear motion. It is sliding left and right, and to that a follower is connected, which is shown in red color. So as the cam reciprocates towards left and right, the follower is moving up and down. So it is not necessary that the cam has always rotary shape. It has other shapes also. So here you can see the cam which is having another shape other than a rotary shape. So here the cam is a reciprocating member which is reciprocating left and right, and the follower is reciprocating up and down. So this is the example of a cam which has another shape. Another example we can see. Okay, before that, this is nothing but the distance moved by the follower in its one reciprocation. So the follower is at the bottom end, and then the follower moves at its top end. So that distance traveled whenever the cam completes its one rotation, that is nothing but lift of the follower. Now here you can see the shape of the cam is cylindrical. Okay. So the earlier example which I have given, in that the shape of the follower, or it is a rotary member, and shape was also rotary or cylindrical. The shape is also circular, whereas in second, that the cam was a reciprocating member. Here you can see the cam has a cylindrical shape. So the portion shown in blue color, that is nothing but cam, which has a cylindrical shape, and on that cylinder the follower is mounted, which is shown in greenish color. So as the cam rotates, the follower will reciprocate, and the motion of the follower depends on the profile of this cylindrical cam. If you change the profile of cylindrical cam, you will get different types of follower motion. So cam can also be cylindrically shaped. So this is an example of cylindrical cam. Again, one more example. So the examples which we have discussed till this slide, in all that example, the follower was a reciprocating member. So the follower has a reciprocatory motion, whereas the cam has a rotary motion. And the purpose of cam and follower is to convert rotary motion into a reciprocating motion, right? But the example which, or the animation which you can see over your screen here, the cam is a rotary member, whereas the follower is a oscillating member. So this is also one of the possibility, right? So it is not necessary that the follower has always a reciprocating motion. It may have a oscillating motion also. So here you can see the cam is there, which is shown in gray color. It is rotating with its uniform velocity, and as it rotates, the follower oscillates over the cam. So whenever you want to convert rotary motion into a oscillatory motion, in that case also you can use a cam and follower. In that case, cam will be a rotary member, whereas follower will be a reciprocating member. So from this example, it is clear how the rotary motion is converted into a reciprocating motion of the follower. So I hope you have understood all the things related to cam and follower. In my next video, I am going to discuss other things related to cam and follower. Thank you so much for watching my video. Thank you.